In this Ticketbud tutorial, we run through event settings. So once you've created your first event and gone through the Getting Started checklist, that gave you the basics, but now we want to dive a little deeper into your event settings to show you what you can do. So from your account, you will click into the event dashboard by selecting the Manage Event button. This takes you to your event dashboard. From here, click on Event Settings. As part of the initial Getting Started checklist, you would have come here to configure your payment processor, which is the provider that secures and distributes your event funds. The Event Settings page also includes your event terms and conditions. Click on this tab and you'll be able to customize your terms and conditions for this event. Your attendees will have to agree to these conditions at checkout. These are separate from Ticketbud's terms and conditions. Remember to save after making edits. Next is your thank you page. We have a standard message that automatically appears on the ticket confirmation thank you page that attendees see after they register or purchase a ticket. You can customize the thank you page message as you wish. Alternatively, you can add a custom redirect link, which is a specific URL that you want attendees to be taken to after they finish their ticket order. This would be instead of the thank you page template. Once you've made changes, hit save. The next tab is for ticket emails. When attendee orders a ticket, they are identified as the purchaser. The purchaser email is the confirmation email you send to the person who completed the ticket order. Here, you can thank them for ordering a ticket and highlight any special details that might improve their experience. Something like, "Thanks for ordering tickets for the X Foundation charity concert. Get ready for an awesome event. Here are some helpful tips to ensure you have a great time." And then you could add things like driving and parking tips, public transport options, things to bring, things not to bring. You get the idea. The ticket holder email can be mostly the same information. Just keep in mind that these are people who have had the ticket ordered by someone else. So your introduction might be slightly different. Something like, "It looks like you're joining us for the X Foundation charity concert. Get ready for an awesome event." And the rest of the information could be the same. This checkbox below the emails allows you to display the tickets directly in the confirmation email. If you uncheck this, the tickets will only be viewable as an email attachment. We recommend keeping the tickets displayed directly in the email as it makes event day check-in much faster. It's easier for guests to get their ticket ready for scanning. Again, save changes. So let's jump back into the main section of event settings. Further down this page, you'll see more options for event settings. This includes visibility. When you first created the event, you would have chosen whether you wanted the event to be open to the public, private, or invitation only. If you ever want to change this, you can do so here. Other event options include the ability to have an event location map appear on your event page. This is automatically selected when you create an event, but you can remove it if you wish. This is what the map looks like at the bottom of your event page. It will appear below your event description content. The Show Other Upcoming Events option is great if you have created multiple events under your account. It gives you the option to show and promote your other events at the bottom of your event page. This is a great opportunity for cross-promotion. Your other events will appear like this. If this is an event that has been created under an organization profile, then it will only show the active events for that organization. If you have a need to create organizations or event groups under your account, you can always reach out to us for additional help with this. So the next option is Show Calendar Above Tickets. If you have multiple events or event sessions, a ticket calendar can be added above your tickets on your event page. That looks like this. When you have an event scheduled over multiple days, calendar functionality makes it quick and easy for ticket buyers to select the day and potentially the time they want to attend. This allows organizers to show events and activities clearly over a number of days. Next, we automatically include the event date and time on tickets and Apple Wallet passes. However, you can remove this here if you wish. So you can also add custom questions for people to answer when they order tickets for your event. We'll go through that in another video. However, here is where you can choose whether to display those custom questions and answers on the order confirmation. If, for example, you asked people their dietary requirements, you might want to include that in the order confirmation so they have a copy of it. Next up, we have the contact email you're using to communicate with attendees. When you send an email, this is the address you want them to be able to reach you at. Time zone is something you would have selected when creating your event, however, you can change it here if you need to. Notification settings allows you to opt into alerts that are sent to you about your event ticket sales and attendee check-ins. Here you can manage the frequency of those notifications. You can also share sales summaries with key stakeholders by subscribing them to receive notifications. So now you know all about your event settings options.